sports. It's in the game.
It's the National Football League on EA Sports. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the New York Giants and the Detroit Lions. And it's all up next.
First opened in 2002. There's a look inside Ford Field here in downtown Detroit, the Motor City. Today, we've got a solid matchup in store in the NFC, as it'll be the New York Giants taking on the Detroit Lions. Brandon Gaudin alongside Charles Davis. Before kickoff, Charles, quickly, your keys to the game.
Well, partner, I can give you the standard ones, turnovers, special teams play. But here's one that doesn't get talked about much anymore, and that's time of possession. Whoever controls the football, gives their defense a break, and takes care of business, that's the team that's going to win this ball game.
The kicker, Graham Gano, set to put his foot into this one. And we are underway from Ford Field. And they're going to mark that where it went out of bounds. So really good starting field position up past the 40-yard line. Wishing he had a mulligan. That's not how you want to start the game.
Not at all, because not only do you give up the penalty and good field position, but it just kills the momentum of your team as you start a game.
Up the middle, it's Montgomery. And that's not the start that he was looking for, as he's going to be met and dropped behind the line. Call it officially a loss of two on the first play from scrimmage, second down.
Well, that kind of hit will certainly fire up your team, both on the field and on the sideline. Tackles for lost yardage, they're always welcome.
Back to Montgomery on second down. Yeah, he'll work free from one tackle, but that's about all as he's taken down.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
A tough spot here on their opening drive. This is third and seven. Goff now to throw. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. Kayvon Thibodeau, he beat the O-line and recorded the sack.
It always helps for a visiting team to come in and set the tone on defense. In fact, when we talked with them prior to the game, they said they wanted this home crowd to feel like they had to hide their valuables when they were in town.
Well, the home crowd quiet now early. See if their offense can take over and get some points on the board. On fourth down, Jack Fox on to punt for Detroit. And back deep, Gunnar Olszewski. It'll be 37 yards there on the punt, and it'll be Giant football first and 10. The former number six overall pick of 2019, Daniel Jones, trots out to lead this New York Giants offense.
I still remember when he was drafted, there was a little bit of controversy about how high he was selected by the New York Giants, but his talents were revealed. He can make every throw in the book. Surprisingly good athlete. As long as he takes care of the football, doesn't turn it over, he can really make plays.
Now Jones. Open target here, Darius Slayton. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44.
But that's what you're looking for when you want to throw the ball downfield. You want one of those guys who can play out on the perimeter, can play out wide, who can not only get open, but when they're covered, can uncover themselves downfield and create catches.
Jones fakes the give to Barkley. And that nearly an interception here on this opening drive, but he gets a reprieve. It's third down.
And I think he was a little surprised to see the ball sitting out there like that. That's a ball he had a chance to come away with, but it winds up an incomplete pass.
After the incompletion, here now, third and two. Throwing Jones. Pass taken in by his big tight end. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. It's a gain of 11 and a Giant first down.
I got a kick out of that one, partner. You and I talk often about trying to hide receivers in certain situations, but a guy of his size can't really hide him. But the tight end drag route, definitely an effective way to sneak him across the formation for an easy completion and a first down.
They go play action here on first down. This one goes out wide for Barkley. Still going. Touchdown, Giants. Saquon Barkley, 45 yards. And the Giants get the upper hand as they're on the board first here this afternoon. Both sides of the football in sync early. You force the three and out, and then you take it down, score points.
You know what that tells me? They sold their game plan really well. Head coach said, listen, we're just going to stop them on three and out. We're going to take the ball downfield and score. But he also told them how it was going to happen. They're going to run this. We're going to stuff it. Then we're going to take the ball. They won't be able to keep up with us. And they got it done.
Jones throwing for it. And this one incomplete. So they went for the two. They don't get it. Tough there. Good pass. Hit the hands. He just couldn't bring it in.
And every receiver's coach everywhere seeing that play, focus, focus, focus. Watch it all the way in and tuck it away.
So they went for two and failed. They didn't use him on the PAT, but now he boots this one away with a 6-0 lead. And trouble there on the kickoff as that goes out of bounds. So now the possession will begin at the 35 after the errant kickoff.
Well, that's certainly one way to avoid a dangerous kick returner, I suppose, but you are giving up extra yardage, that's for sure. Because if you put it out of the end zone, they start at the 25. So at a minimum, you're giving up 10 yards to the offense.
Goff. A little short pass here taken in by Laporta. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And that'll make it second down. Now Goff. It's Reynolds, and he's going to be taken down. Plus, there's a penalty flag in the backfield. They may get 15 more on top of this. So certainly a defensive mistake here in the first quarter, getting hit with a roughing the passer call.
And that hurts not just because of the yardage you gave up and give them a fresh set of downs, but that brought the home crowd into this one. And when you go on the road, your job is to silence the crowd.
Second quarter action now from Detroit, and it's the homestanding Lions who have the football as they've got it with a first and 10. Now Goff. And his throw here is incomplete.
But there's an incompletion, partner, and the struggles through the air continue because so far their lack of passing production has led to a lack of points.
Second and 10. Off play action. Here's Goff. Complete to right. And he's going to lose yardage and be backed up to the 25. 2 yards the loss, and now third and 12.
In today's NFL, we're accustomed to the tight end getting downfield and creating plays and wreaking a little havoc in the secondary. Not on this one, though. They diagnosed that one really well.
Tried the dump off, lost yardage. Now that'll be caught by St. Brown. And he's going to be stopped well short of what he needed as the tackle is made at the 18-yard line. That'll go for a gain of 7, And that's going to bring up a fourth down.
So much about this game is just understanding situations and then having to execute, isn't it? Guard the first down sticks. Don't let them get there. And they rallied and made the tackle.
2 minutes remaining in this first half of football. Here's Michael Badgley ready for the field goal try. This just a 35-yard attempt from the left hash. Badgley's kick is good, and they are on the board, trailing now 6-3. So the big return had them fired up, but in the end, the offense stalls out. They only muster three.
Yeah, the excitement was there after the return, but they didn't move the ball at all after that. They didn't even get a first down.
So just a 3-point game now as they send this one away. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27. So the Giants getting the football back here for their second drive. This drive here beginning probably with a pair of motivated groups. Remember, the offense scored a touchdown on their last time out, looking to repeat that. Charles's defense, they were very frustrated after giving up six the last time on the field.
And frankly, it's just a battle of wills in a lot of ways, because you know they're both motivated, they both game plan for this drive, and they both have specific outcomes in mind. To me, it just comes down to who can execute better and which side can step up and assert its will over the other.
Now a second and 10. To throw again, Jones. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Zone coverage there, and they were playing deep. That makes it obviously a little bit harder to run by guys. And that time, it's not much of a window to get the ball in there, and it winds up incomplete.
So back-to-back incompletions, and that has him staring at a 3rd and 10. Jones with a handoff to Barkley, and this effort will not get it done. He stopped well short of the first down at the 29. On fourth down, here's Jamie Gillen on to punt. And how about this, a fake? And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. And the Lions will get the football back in terrific field position. Detroit's offense ready to take over. Still in the first half, but this offense has struggled. Haven't really been able to get anything going, not only in the points category, but in the yards category. Let's see if they can do better here on this drive. Under pressure, and he will go down. Sacked back at the 38. Throwing on second and long. Goff. That is incomplete.
Well, partner, guaranteed they approach this play with the idea of making up ground to make third down manageable. Unfortunately, with that incompletion, right back where they started on the last snap. Now they need a big third down play in order to pick up the yardage needed.
He's airing it out for Williams. And this one dropped in the end zone. Looked like a touchdown, but not to be. And now it's fourth down.
Oh, that's going to hurt a bit because they needed to come through with a completion there. Now a drive that started with great field position is facing fourth down.
And here now the punter Fox as he sends this one away. The Giants now going to take over late in this first half. Just inside of a minute left, Charles. They got a pretty long field ahead of them. I'm curious to see how they play this, but you would think definitely enough time to at least try to get three out of this.
Yeah, you want to move with a nice sense of pace. You want to up the tempo a little bit, but you have to do it with some poise as well. You don't want to go so fast that you hurry yourself into mistakes. There's enough time to put points on the board if they do it right.
And even though they have the lead, you know that they would love to extend this lead before heading to the locker room.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well, and every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
Another throw on second down, and this one incomplete as well.
A couple of quick incompletions, and now they just walk away from getting off the field. They've got options now. Could they dial up the blitz here, or just drop everyone into coverage to crowd the throwing lanes?
Now they face a 3rd and 10 after back-to-back incompletions. They'll try the right side here, Barkley. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That good for 22 and a first down.
Just about every coach we talk to says the crowd shouldn't affect us. That shouldn't be an issue. And then the next breath they talk about taking the crowd and taking them out of the game by picking up first downs and keeping them at bay. I think we just saw an example of that there, didn't we?
Important to do, especially early in the game like they have. So a solid run by Saquon Barkley and another first and 10 here. Looking to throw. Jones. And that's going to be incomplete.
That's some good closing speed there defensively because that looked open for a minute. That's great work with the ball in the air. Never gave up. Converged on his man and broke the play up.
Here's second and 10. Back to throw. Jones. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
And they're not going to go quietly into this halftime break. They know they're in for a fight, so they're trying to make every possession count. They took the big shot there, but it winds up incomplete.
Now, meanwhile, a pass that should have been intercepted, but it winds up falling incomplete.
Give them credit for excellent coverage, tight coverage. They're doing a lot of things that we talk about in basketball. They're causing disruptions in the passing game. And as long as that continues, it'll be tough for them to gain any momentum throwing the ball downfield.
Now they're going to try this again. It's another fake. And this is incomplete. A huge gamble, and it does not pay off. They fake the punt. It doesn't work out. And that will force a turnover on downs. And that is no good. Oh, he missed it just wide of the upright. So we've hit halftime. Just a field goal separating these two teams at the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Back to you guys in a bit. But first, we welcome everyone to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Adjustments being made in both locker rooms. They are just about set to get back to football in Detroit. And for the call of the second half, we'll kick it back up to Ford Field and Brandon Godd.
Okay, Coach. Yeah, adjustments likely going to play a big role in this third quarter. Contest so far. Second half ready to get rolling. The Giants with a lead and they are set to receive this kick. Oh, a dangerous return man showing it here. Still going past the 30. And he'll bring it back all the way. Touchdown, Giants. Now, people still trying to get back to their seats from the concession stand here at the start of the third quarter, and boom, we got points on the board.
And you just identified why the bulk of stadiums have increased presence in the concession areas, right? TVs, loudspeakers, so people can still follow the game. And right now, they're bummed out that they missed that big return to start this half.
Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. It's caught inside the five, and he gets in. Well, no one was expecting a fake there, but they add two more onto their lead. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff. Right after the touchdown to extend their lead, now maybe opening the door a little bit there by allowing starting field position at the 40. Well, you don't see that often. He just mishit it, and it goes out of bounds.
Well, I know sitting up here, and I'm looking at you, and you're looking at me, and I know we're both thinking the same thing. Isn't it easy enough to keep it between the sidelines? Because unless you're intentionally doing it for some reason, but that's a costly mishit, and now you put your team in a bad spot.
Here's a fake on the jet sweep, and instead a give up the middle. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. Dexter Lawrence finding his way through defensively for the stop.
This defense is just flat getting after it. They have not given up much of anything in the run game. Case in point right there.
Back to throw. Gone. And the giant rush gets home as down he goes. A'shaun Robinson, too much to handle that time, gets the sack.
So one quick, easy analysis about why they struggled so far. They keep putting themselves in third and long situations. They just took another sack right there.
And the offensive film session tomorrow may be a little longer than it normally is.
Not a lot of positive grades will be handed out thus far.
So now following the sack, Goff and the Lions needing to come up with something here on third and long. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. And the Giants have it. It's picked. And this is taken into the end zone. A fumble recovery and a Giants touchdown. The offense, they've had some sloppy moments. Sloppy there again on that one, and it could be the backbreaker.
From a defensive perspective, if the offense is going to be sloppy, you've got to take advantage of that. And that's what they've done all game long.
Graham Gano on for the extra point. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And that'll be incomplete.
Well, I have to admit, I'm scratching my head a little bit here trying to make sense of what I just saw. Number one, huge lead. Just kick the extra point and be done with it. Number two, if you are going to go for two, just line up and go for it from the two-yard line. Why make it so difficult? That's a long way to go to try and pick up some points.
Graham Gano to kick off for New York.
So here's the kickoff now as he'll get it again following that fumble return for a score. A break there for this offense as they will get a chance to start at the 40-yard line.
Free kick out of bounds. Kicking team.
Well, not one you see often there as he fails to keep it between the sidelines, and that is a penalty every time and going to give this offense better field position.
And it's every kickoff guy's nightmare, isn't it? Because you don't see yourself doing this, and most of the time you don't. It's absolutely a mishit, and now your team pays the price. Bad field position for your defense.
And he goes out of bounds. It looks like right at the 50. So the completion results there in 9 yards, and it'll bring up a second and short. Out of the gun, they'll give to Gibbs. 4 yards the pickup, first down.
Second and one is often an invitation to take the big shot downfield. I'll bet the offensive lineman said, are you kidding? We just get on our backs and let's go get the first down. They love being physical.
Now a first down throw. Gone. And he's going to be swallowed up. Sacked back at the 45-yard line. It'll be a loss of 10. And it'll bring up second.
I think we've seen this before. Someone's down 3 scores. That situation there,
It's just going to add to their growing frustrations, don't you think?
Yeah, a bad number three right now. Three-score game, third quarter, three and out, not what they wanted. And you can tell on the sideline, those faces are getting a little bit longer as this one goes. On second down, Montgomery. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield. Give him 4 yards there, but still in a big hole. Third and long. So they'll get a little extra time to come up with his third down play as we play three quarters. Back now at Ford Field. It's the Lions trailing, but with possession of the football as we get set to bring you the fourth quarter. Third and long, it's Goff. And he can't get away from the pressure. The Giants get there. All right, they're going to try and keep hope alive here on fourth down. They're going for it. He's airing it out for Williams. It's caught inside the 25.
Pass interference. Defense.
So they will wave off the flag and let the completion stand.
Really great job by the receiver fighting through all the contact and still coming down with the football. All that great work in practice being put into the game.
And he's heating up at the line of scrimmage. Might have gotten a yard down to the 16. Here's Goff. This is caught. And the Lions are going to be set up with a first and goal on a pass play that moves them all the way down to the one. Goff. He's got his man. It's caught for a Lion touchdown. Jared Goff to Amon-Ra St. Brown. And the Lions are finally into the end zone here in this fourth quarter. Michael Badgley on for the extra point. It's up, it's good. That'll make the score line 20-10. Two scores down, three timeouts left. Still a chance if they can somehow get this one back. And this is going to be covered up by the Giants. They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. New York ready to go again offensively. And a few kneel downs should just about do it. Now, defensively, they do have all three timeouts, but very little reason to use them at this point. We've got to have two hands on the football here as they run on first down. And he's corralled, but not before getting it inside the 35. And now we're going to get a timeout defensively. So another stop, 1:50 left in the football game. So they'll come up first and 10 now from the 33. Again, it's Barkley. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. The Lions now going to use the second of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On second down, here's a keeper by the QB. The Lions quickly now going to use the last of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. Here's Jones to throw. That is caught. And he is going to have a New York first down, and the Giants are going to win the football game.
Oftentimes we think of those tough yards as grinding yards that a running back has to pick up. How about the tight end there picking up the first down in that situation?
That's what he's there for, right?
Big fella, get it to him. Let him fight off some people and pick up the necessary yardage.
5 points of contact necessary at this stage as they'll run on first down. And boy, showing how tough he can be to bring down, just fighting his way forward to pick up 7 yards.
I like the call there because that was one to take time off the clock and get them closer to getting out of here with a W. In the mind of the play caller, all you want to hear is tick, tick, tick.
And they corral him just a couple yards shy of the end zone. It'll go as a gain of 12, and that should just about wrap this one up.
I know we're in the era of wide-open football, a lot of sprint formations, more space, but there's still a spot for power football, and we just saw some of it right there. How about that run?
Yeah, breaking the tackle, and, you know, late in this game, he wants a football in his hands. He's had a good day. Well, they probably don't need to run a play here, but you wonder if they're going to be able to resist on first and goal. Here's a fake on the jet sweep as he'll go instead with Barkley. And that one blown up quickly as he's going to be stopped before he could even get started. That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
Sometimes you get all those big guys down there in one spot and there's just nowhere to go. And in this case, the defensive tackle used his strength and swallowed him up.
On second down, here's Barkley. Stopped short, down at the one. Had the broken tackle, but couldn't get it all the way home. So a victory here for the men in blue, the New York Giants. And you and I, we just looked at each other and kind of had the same thought. I don't think that we saw this result coming. If they were going to win, maybe at home, but not here on the road.
No, not at all. We thought that at the end, you know, the strength would win out. And that didn't happen. But let's give them credit. Went on the road without being intimidated. Went on the road with not just belief, but a strong belief that they could pull it off, and took advantage of every opportunity in this one.
So that'll do it for my partner, Charles Davis, and the best darn crew in the industry. I'm Brandon Gaughton. This has been a presentation of the NFL on EA Sports. With that, we say so long.